Hi there, and welcome to another visionarydining.com video. First of all, a very happy new year to you. It's going to be a very busy year for us as we continue touring the country, discovering fantastic chefs, exploring interesting concepts. And today I have a really interesting chef that I've been wanting to meet for quite some time. I'd like you to meet Gary McKechnie. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
From Harbour and Jones.
Yes.
Now, a lot of people watching this at the moment are going to say, right, I've just been watching Jason Atherton and Tom Aikins, and who are you?
Well, we are a contract caterer. We're one of the smaller ones, contract caterer. We're a bespoke company. We've got great ethics. Our ethics are pure food, mostly food orientated. We've got contracts all around the city and on the outskirts of London as well. And they range from top banks to Selfridges to St Paul's Cathedral. So a complete varied sort of spectrum of different food aspects within.
Okay, so the image that contract catering has for the people who watch this, I think fish fingers, dinner ladies.
I think then those are very few now, to be perfectly honest.
So if you could tell us what a chef would learn if they came to work for you.
Well, I think, to be honest, contract catering, you can, as a young chef, you can cover a complete spectrum of your basic staff dining right up to private dining rooms with, you know, no budget of food as such. So we have young chefs that come on board and, you know, they do sort of different time scales within our sites, and they can come out a very well-rounded chef. You know, so it's a complete spectrum of what we do within catering. So yeah.
And when we'd say fine dining, we're talking about some of the top executive boards in the country.
Yeah, we look after the London Stock Exchange, Catlin's, FCA, and all of them have really private fine dining rooms. And some of the tables have no budgets at all. So you know, and we look after some premium.
I think a lot of chefs would want to hear that.
Yeah. But then again, you can go down the spectrum as well, where we run some sites with some very tight budgets as well. Mm. So not only do chefs get good cooking skills as well, but they learn about their finances, about their GPs. We push them hard on that because, obviously, in some cases we have tight GPs to make. So
yeah.
Mm. So they do get a complete spectrum of the whole catering thing. And again, it's not only about sort of your fish fingers and that. Yes, we have cheaper contracts in the business, but we have a higher contracts as well.
I think it's like the higher end where I think really, really aspirational chefs. I know chefs that might work in a Michelin star restaurant for 3 years, then actually go into contract catering, continue their career, and then come out into another Michelin star restaurant. So you are cooking at that level.
Most definitely are, yeah. I mean, a couple of our contracts, we've had guys from Michelin star restaurants that have done very, very well. Sometimes they find the changeover difficult, but once they sort of get into the actual service, because service obviously is not as long because you're serving for a set time instead of a four-hour service.
That change, I'm sure there's going to be people sending me emails, but that change, I think, is the change and the move into being organised, probably.
Most definitely. I mean, you are dear to a service time, as you do, and your service, you know, if a chairman wants his lunch at 1:30, it's 1:30 it is. You don't argue with the chairman, at the end of the day he's paying your wages, so yeah.
What do you think the fact that you have this environment out there, not just with Harbour and Jones, but other companies that are doing fantastic food, that it's not being reflected by the guides? Is there anything on that?
It is a shame because there's some really talented guys within our sort of sector of catering, but yeah, I think it should be. A criterion needs to be set where we can be marked and we can put ourselves out there within, the catering industry. Because there are some very talented guys out there. So, yeah, definitely.
Very good. Right, well, I think that's just really covered off the headlines of who you are. And by way of thanks for sharing your time with us, I have a little gift for you. And I would like to present you with this cucumber.
Thank you very much.
Now, the viewers might think that is slightly odd. But we're about to move on to the McKnife Cucumber Challenge, which is sponsored by CCS, chefs.net. You've seen the videos?
I have seen the videos, yeah.
How do you feel about...
Yeah, I'm a bit worried about my fingers, to be honest. I know these knives are pretty sharp, and I don't really use a Mac, but I dare say after this I will be. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to the challenge.
And we've offered you the chainmail glove.
Yeah.
and you wanted a suit of armour as well.
Oh, I do actually, yeah.
A suit of armour as well. Okay, but you are going in with a naked hand.
Yes, most definitely, without a doubt.
Yeah. Good job I mentioned ham there, wasn't
no
it?
No blood
absolutely.
At the moment.
Absolutely, sure. So why don't we get to the chopping block and see what we can
Let's
do?
Let's go for it, yeah.
Great stuff, Gary. Cheers.
Thank you.
Okay, pick up the knife. On your marks, get set, go.
Does it get a beer as well? Just to
privileged.
How was that for you?
Yeah, good, yeah. The most hardest bit is taking the cellophane.
It's a killer for all the chefs. Mm. They know they can chop really quickly, but when it comes to taking that wrapper off, you can see,
And again, just getting used to that knife, I haven't used it before, straight in, so yeah, it's good.
And you know it's gonna really bite if it hits you as well.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'm really pleased to say that and this is a this goes back to how we began this conversation, is that you've hit mid-table with 3.5 slices per second.
Fantastic.
Which is absolutely awesome, really.
Good, thank you.
You've actually taken a few scalps from the Michelin star restaurant there.
Can't be bad.
So that's a good little...
Fantastic.
Good stuff. Well, thanks very much
for
your time.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
And we'll see you again soon.
Much appreciated. Thank you.
Thank you.